Hey guys, it's ViewMasters Reactions, and we're back with another new show. Barry starts in about an hour, exactly an hour from now. It just hit 9 o'clock. These are like 50 minutes, so I felt like jumping into something new to keep me hyped up for Barry. I had nothing to do. I got all my stuff done, left just enough time for this, and I'm gonna literally jump right into Barry season 4, episode 1. You guys won't even see this till after Barry has come out, probably at least the first 2 episodes. But I plan on running with this. You guys told me about it on the live stream. You said, Jay, go check this out. I told you, if you were in the live stream for campaign 2, we do them every Friday, 7:45. We're on for 2 or 3 hours. We were talking about new shows that are in the 80s/90s, basically my teenage years. I was born in 81. This falls right around there. Like I was 12, 13, maybe. I don't know. But I only saw the movies recently. I said this before in the live streams as well. I saw the first Highlander, I want to say like 3 years ago. I remember I went to a convention. It was either a Comic-Con or a Monster Mania in Cherry Hill. And there were lots of props, obviously, like people selling stuff. And something came up with Highlander. I think it was a sword or something. Obviously, there's lots of swords. But something came up dealing with Highlander. And I remember being like, I'd never seen it before. And I was with Michelle at the time. Those of you who have known my ex-girlfriends as time has gone on, it had to have been less than 3 years ago because I didn't know her before then. And we were somewhere and she's like, how do you not know Highlander? It is Queen. She's a big music person. We immediately went home and watched it. And then I watched what I believe is the rest of them. I know I watched at least 2 more, possibly 3. I know there's at least 3. Then there's this show that I didn't even know existed. I don't know if Christopher Lambert's in this. I don't know if Sean Connery's in this. Probably not on both. If anybody's going to be in it, it's Christopher Lambert. I did not look at anything on IMDb. I am going in as blind as possible. I know that is obviously not Christopher Lambert. I don't know if I recognize him. It's very shadowed. But the movie, the first one, all-star cast, Clancy Brown, Sean Connery, Christopher Lambert. I enjoy him for what he is. His acting is something, but I enjoy him. I think he fits in that role great. And there was lots of sword fighting and head cutting off. And let's just jump in and we'll talk more at the end. You guys want to see more of what I do? Full unedited episodes of everything on the channel. In the description of every video is a link for Patreon. You'll see these in full. If you're seeing this one, we're probably a couple episodes ahead, but I'm going to try to get rolling with this. Peaky Blinders, Doctor Who, Farscape, Legend of Korra, Death Note, hundreds of other shows and movies. Check the link for Patreon. If not, Highlander, Season 1, Episode 1. I started running again. I told you guys this in other videos. And now, I guess because I smoke, I'm choking up the world.
I was born 400 years ago in the Highlands of Scotland. I am immortal, and I'm not alone.
But
now is the time of the gathering.
Got right into
the stroke
it.
Of a sword will release the power of the quickening.
The gathering. The
in
quickening.
The end, there can be only one.
The gathering was New York City, 1985. They even have the music. I'm pretty happy they got the music. It's a great song. Here we are. Hey! It's got the look of the world. Who is the dude? I don't recognize him. Adrian Paul? Episode 1, The Gathering. All right. Guest star, Christopher Lambert as Connor McLeod. Richard Mull. That's Bull from Night Court. What was this on? What channel was this on? Richard Mull. What did I just see him in? Richard Mull from Night Court was in something else too. Was he in Lex? Was this the guy in the intro? Is that Kirsch dude? It kind of looks like the dude that was in the intro. Like, the guy that wasn't the main guy.
Mac.
Mac? So he's McLeod. Mac? Unless that's his first name. Is he Mac McLeod?
Duncan, be careful.
Duncan. Duncan McLeod. This dude is in pretty good shape. Adrian something? I didn't remember the last name.
On guard, you fool.
On guard.
I am Duncan McLeod of the Clan McLeod.
Clan McLeod. This
you
dude just
dead.
And you are dead.
Dead?
This dude broke into the wrong house.
Whoa.
Does he think he's part of the gathering?
I ripped off a couple of cups in a bowl. I'm sorry, all right?
It's over when I cut off your head.
Yeah, he thinks he's part of it.
You don't think that's a little extreme for petty theft?
Oh, someone is here, though. So he is. All right. I was going to say, wouldn't he have had a feeling about it? Whoa. All right, so there is a guy here. I got to turn this down. I got way too loud. Look at this dude. Is this Mad Max?
Funniest home videos, right?
Who is this crazy dude?
I'm Slan Quince, and I've come for your head.
Slan Quince? Hey, that sounded like Clancy Brown kind of, didn't it? It's not. But it had a Quince.
We haven't been properly introduced. But you'll get to know me, my dear.
Doesn't he sound like Clancy Brown a little bit?
Did you come to fight or talk?
He's not gonna fight you, Duncan.
Oh! Connor's already here. What happens to Connor? Is he in... It said guess.
Not until he's made you suffer. Until he's
very interesting.
Everything you love in this world. Until you don't know whether you want to live or die. That's your way, right, Slan?
Connor, what are you doing here?
Headhunting.
Headhunting.
Sorry, Duncan, but this one is mine.
Man, these guys are out there.
My challenge was to Duncan MacLeod, not you, whoever you are.
I'm Connor.
Oh, that's Bull.
Same clan.
That's Chris. That's Richard Mole.
Yes.
I don't think I've ever seen Richard Mole with hair. He sounds
not
like
two against one.
Thanks, Slan. I know the rules. You and me. Now.
Not two against one. Those are the rules. Does he kill Connor? Because I feel like he's not
part of it. Sounds
to me like
we're about to have company, gentlemen.
We would have seen it. Put it this way.
Charming lady of the house.
The theme song would have had Christopher Lambert as a character and not a guest appearance. If he was not, he's either going to leave or die in this episode. Thanks, Richard Mull. You just shattered our window in slow motion. I hope Connor doesn't die. That would kind of like ruin it. I don't want to know he died in the first episode of the TV show.
You look good.
Look at the laugh. His laugh is great.
Richie Ryan?
That's his name, yeah.
Richie Ryan.
Look, I don't understand. We caught this kid. We can make a good case against him, but not if you don't press charges.
Sorry, no charges.
Look, let me tell you something. This punk is trying to get off the hook by saying he didn't break in.
I mean,
he heard a disturbance, looked
I
inside.
Hope
he saw
Duncan has an idea
of swords
for
having it out.
Did he also see a guy in a bat costume and a long cape?
Okay. Anyway. Now, he had jewelry from your shop in his pocket when we nabbed him running from the scene. We got him dead to rights.
There
Sorry.
Was a robbery in the first one, too. He went to
Can
jail.
Can I talk to him before you let him go?
Honestly, sir, I really do appreciate this second chance you're going to give me to become a useful member of society.
If I let you out of here, I do not want anyone coming around asking about your little fantasies.
That is the deal.
Fantasies. Oh, you mean like the one where you and the Knights of the Round Table were right? Never saw a thing. Just made it all up. I know. I'm fast. All my teachers said so. Fast but lazy.
Is he gonna try to blackmail him? Or is he gonna follow? Dude, you're not convincing me. You act like a douche. You're not
Besides,
convincing
what
me.
What I tell, you know?
Everybody, that information could be worth a lot. Just go tell more thieves, yo, this guy's got crazy antique swords worth a lot of money. Look at his face. He's holding that face for like 5 years. It started the show with him having sex, but they didn't show anything then. I honestly thought they were very slick with the not showing nudity. So I thought it was
this wine from
PG.
Napoleon's own cellar. Suppose.
After I watch this episode and then I do Barry, tonight or tomorrow I'm gonna watch the movie again. I feel like she might be related.
You'll
beautiful.
To somebody from the other one.
And a year older.
He made the mistake that Connor made. He fell in love.
Tessa,
and now his
most
wife
wonderful woman I've known in my entire life.
Is getting older.
Well,
I mean, she still looks pretty good.
Years?
Well, 400.
But that's going to end in like
well,
40
for,
years.
Another 4 months.
The problem is, even when you are 400 or 420, you will still look 35.
I want to live forever. I know that's not the words. It's like, who wants to live forever,
others,
right?
Other loves. After a century or two, do you learn how to cope?
Cope?
With the loss of love.
With the loss?
Yes, Duncan.
No matter how many years go by, or how many times you say goodbye to those you care most about, when they leave, you
die.
Yes.
She's like, no, I'm going to die. I'm not going to leave. I'm going to die.
You're naked and
I'm going to be old and die.
Why didn't we stop thinking about?
Yeah, I in all honesty, you, it ain't like you didn't know this.
Or 440.
Let's talk
or,
about it in 40 years when I throw you out the window. There's Richard Mull. Richard Mull, I don't know if I've ever seen this man with hair, and he's got a lot. When he was talking before, damn, man, he's even got facial. He's like got a full stash with a beard and a full head of hair. Is he going to kill Duncan's girl? Because this is what Clancy Brown did. Clancy Brown went after Connor's girl. Literally violated her and left her alive so he'd have to live with it. Is this dude going to do something similar? Is he going to, like, violate Duncan's girl? Kill her? I mean, that also doesn't make me feel too good. She was just talking about, you know, I'm going to die one day. I think she might die now. We're almost halfway through the episode. Oh, it's Connor. Never mind. I was going to say, is it just Connor? Because we saw Connor and Bull.
Hi. Tessa, you've already met Connor McLeod.
I am a friend of Duncan's from the old neighborhood.
From the old neighborhood. 16th century Scotland, to be exact. Are we going to train? That's a training session. One thing I appreciate, too, is the sword fighting is great. Christopher Lambert, I mean, I'm assuming he knows what he's doing, but he makes it look good if he doesn't. I mean,
you're pinprick.
By my count, you look more like a pincushion.
Smacked him on the butt. He's got a puffy shirt like Seinfeld. It looks kind of like it. It's not exact. Looks like a pirate.
You know Slan is mine.
You sure you can handle him? Come on.
No problem.
Helps him up and throws him. I like all the twirling and fanciness. It's a lot of show, but looks good. I want to see. What I'm afraid of is they're going to go back in the house and...
That is mine.
Protecting Tessa is my job.
Protecting Tessa is my job.
Let me just go in the next room and crochet while you have cigars and brandy and talk about beheadings.
It's not about being a man, lady. It's about we are 400 years old and sword fight to the death.
She didn't need to know all the rules.
You're not out of it anymore. There can be only one.
There can be only one.
Remember that rule?
That was what Sean Connery always said. So one of them's got to kill each other. Is that what it is? Maybe Connor goes, listen.
One of you?
I taught you everything.
Only one immortal left in the end?
Yeah, so one of you got to die,
is
like Sean Connery. There's like an equal to everything in the movie. I dig it, though. There's like the Clancy Brown, the Sean Connery, the Christopher Lambert.
Well, have the power of all the immortals who ever lived.
All the power.
Enough power to rule this planet forever.
So I'm guessing we're...
If someone like Slan is that last one,
Mankind will suffer an eternity of darkness from which it will never recover.
His acting got way better.
This was important enough to mention.
I'm sure he didn't want to be part of it. He clearly, flashback city. He clearly didn't want to be part of it. And we get Queen again. I hope we get music in every episode. I hope they're not just spoiling me in the first episode. And Duncan's girl was murdered.
Two of the names. All the grasses. The wildflowers.
Is that Jeff Ross? Is he gonna roast him?
Some told where people came from. How they lived. What they believed in.
He's a little odd on the emotions. And I think she just opened her eye.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, it's Connor. That was Connor?
Do you think we ever lived like this?
I didn't even recognize that was Connor.
Together with a common language. A reason and a name.
He looks like a dirty, hairy farmer. But he probably is.
Once belongs somewhere. A time. A place. However briefly.
Hey, I loved everything about it. The music. Did he kill Tessa? I keep saying it, but I can't. I'm thinking, like, all right, what is the direction they're going to take the show? Are they making us think that's her and it's Richard Mull?
Tessa?
I don't think it's Tessa.
Hi, hon. Want to see what I've been working on?
Did he kill her? I think he killed her. Oh, no, she's still alive.
I think the face could use a little work. Don't you?
Ah! Is he gonna sand her face?
Not too close. Drop it. Drop it!
Exactly what Connor said. Whoop, look at that. Oh, genius.
He came for me.
Very slick move. He cut the power so the sander or the grinder or whatever it was didn't work anymore. Genius. I'm afraid this dude's gonna kill her, though, before the fight's done.
You know what some wags call me? Slam the cat. Because I like to play with my victims first.
He's hilarious.
Don't spoil the fun. Be a good boy, and I'll leave her alive. This time, I want you to think about it now. I bet you're thinking about it right now, aren't you?
I love the over-the-topness. He's like a perfect actor for this.
Ta-ta for now, kids.
Ta-ta for now. My God, it's hilariously great. I love everything. It's great action scenes, but they're ridiculously over the top and funny. Whether it's intentional or not, it's everything I wanted. How long have they been together? Didn't he say she's only been around long enough to just figure this out? I mean, granted, that's why she's pissed, but I hope they've been together long enough to have heard that eagle screech 500 times. It's one of the greatest sound effects. All right, back to Connor. Look at Connor's outfit. He looks like a homeless man or someone that robbed Indiana Jones after he was thrown off a cliff.
They all do. Men kill men. We kill each other.
I don't care who does the killing. I'm tired of it. I'm tired of the endless, mindless fighting. I'm tired of death.
Is this dude coming back to rob shit, or is he just like, I want to be part of this? I think he's coming back like, let me help. My life sucks. I'm a criminal. We got more music. Universe. You know what's funny? I feel like this show might have been it had nudity, though. If it didn't have the nudity, I would have thought it was like USA or Lifetime. Because I feel like I've seen commercials when I saw Quantum Leap, like back in the early 90s. I used to watch Quantum Leap. That and a lot of game shows. So unless it was on a channel with like USA Up All Night or something like that. Look, this guy's loving it. What was his name? Josh Jenkins or something like that. It was two J's, I feel like. Going to town practicing our Highlanders. This guy's like, I could do that.
Oh, I
How do you feel, old man?
50 years younger than you do.
50 years younger. There you go, 50 years.
As long as I remember knowing you, you've had all the fun and most of the good women.
What?
Lately.
Lately?
That's what I said.
What?
What are you talking about?
Well, I seem to remember that girl in London. The redhead. Healthy girl.
Come on, that was almost 160 years ago.
That's what I said, lately.
Lately?
You know what your problem is? You live in the past.
I don't have a problem.
Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
I don't know
no,
if that's lately.
Stop arguing with me.
I'm not arguing.
If we're 400 years
sure.
old and it was 160
no,
years
it's
ago.
It's conversation.
It's conversation? Well, end of conversation.
Oh, easy way out, huh? Yeah.
It's almost half a lifetime ago. 160 Duncan? Years, that's half a lifetime ago for them. It's not lately, Duncan. Yeah, good job. Thanks,
end
Connor.
Conversation.
End of conversation.
Arguing?
Connor does. I mean, Duncan deserved it.
Don't worry, he's gonna be okay.
Yeah, he'll be fine. He'll be fine. They live
you
forever.
You don't have to go either.
Did he knock him out? Did he literally knock him out with one punch? I absolutely love that Connor knocked him out with one punch. I don't want him to get up. Duncan, don't get up. Don't get up till the scene's over. Yes. He knocked Duncan out with one punch. An immortal. I love it. And Duncan was mouthing off. Who the hell do you think you are? I don't want to find out Connor's off the show because he loses in episode one.
Pretty face of yours.
Just protecting my most valuable asset.
Really, Bull? Your face? I don't think anyone cares about your face. And if that's your most valuable asset, it isn't speaking too fondly of other things. Bull, you don't care about that? Why? I would have like a gigantic shield right here. Like imagine you were immortal and like in your first battle someone whacked your wiener off. You don't want to live forever.
Oh man, these guys should sell tickets.
These guys should sell tickets. Two good hits to La Cabeza. Look at this. I love the shadows. I love the way they're filming it. And like this. This was in the theme song. The grittiness of him driving around and like the city lights. And I love all that. Doing. Yes. He got his face. Oh, he went through the mask. I love it. He went through the mask. And Richard Mull really sold it. Look at his faces. I love it. Oh my God. I think he's getting. Oh, he got Connor. Connor's not dead.
Bye bye.
Connor's not dead. My guess is Connor vanishes for a while. We think he's dead. He comes back. I like how they did that then. He shot a freaking torpedo or something out of his sword hilt. What was it, like something? It looked like a needle. I don't know if it injected him or if it just hit him and lunged him off. Oh, well, Duncan might have to jump on him now. I was going to say, that would pay Duncan back for letting him slide, and we could trust the kid if he did that. The kid is just watching. The kid did not assist at all. The kid would have saw him die. He already watched Connor die. So the kid is not a good assistant at all. But that's pretty cool. Are they going to show us Connor? I don't think so. Beautifully done. Good choreography. Head. Take his head. Is he going to behead him? Oh no, he cut him in the midsection. Dude, that's not how we win. Cut his head off. Yeah, there you go. Oh, is he going to see him do it? Take his head.
Finish it, Highlander.
You better do it.
There can be only one.
Ah, yep, he did it. I was like, please tell me he didn't. I don't want some righteous Highlander that's not going to chop heads off. That's what I'm here for. I'm here for the chopping of douche heads. Up, oh, he's getting Slain's life force or power, whatever you want to call it. And Freddy Krueger has come to life out of the trunk of the car in the junkyard. Look at this lightning. I'll take it. Did he just jump? Dude, that's not how you jump off a bridge in a water holding a sword. He like belly flopped with the sword at an angle. Horrible idea. Can you imagine if he jumped and stabbed? I mean, he's immortal. He's got to be beheaded. Can you imagine if he beheaded himself by jumping off the bridge? I would have. This dude is still watching. And he got Connor. Is it like poison or something?
No, this won't come as a surprise. But you'll live.
What about the boy?
Yeah, recruit the boy.
He'll need watching.
He's in the theme song. We have to.
I will.
There we go. Actually, she was in the cast. Just like I said, the young kid was part of the theme. If she was going to go away, she wouldn't be part of...
I tried to call you.
I should have known that right off the bat. She's part of the show. She's going to come with us. But what about Connor? So they ran off...
I love you.
...and are going to live in the woods.
I love you.
I mean, hey, be together. 12 years is a lot.
You know that.
I didn't know it was that long. I approve of this relationship.
You don't know when it's going to end. Goodbye, Tessa.
One day I will come back, and I'll kill your husband.
Duncan.
Connor.
Very awesome. I dig it. So we know he's alive. I thought they were going to play some mystery game with us. I thought they were going to get rid of Tess.
You didn't say goodbye?
We'll see each other again.
Never do.
Yeah. It ain't the end, lady. One of us got to lose our head. Connor, it was good seeing you. I don't think I'm going to see him for a bit. I hope he comes back. I hope that's not like a one and done. And here we are, we're the princes of the universe. All right, guys, that's it for season one, episode one, Highlander. I am thoroughly impressed. I kid you not. It looks great. The music is everywhere. Very much like the movie Highlander. I remembered as the show was going how much music was infused into the Highlander movie. Almost every time there's a dramatic scene or a fight scene, there is great music, most of it being Queen. I mean, they repeated a lot, but they did in the movie too, and I'm fine with it because I love all the songs and they're great. They're used perfectly. We got Connor McLeod. We learn what is going on here. So there's Duncan McLeod, who is 50 years younger than Connor. Duncan's grandfather was the age of Connor. People might get confused, like my grandfather died at 83, I think. So people might think like, oh, they can live a long time. We're talking back in the 16th century. Grandfathers probably live to 50 if they're lucky. I said 50 was the average number I'd throw at, and then they said 50 years in the show. I don't know if that was exact, but Connor's his elder. We fight Slain, who is Bull from Night Court. Richard Mull with hair. Never seen him with hair before. Great character. Over the top, just how I want him to be. Very much like Clancy Brown. They set this whole first episode up like I feel a carbon copy of the movie, almost, so to speak. We had Duncan sort of as the Connor role, Connor as the Sean Connery role. We had Richard Mull clearly being the Clancy Brown, even with the driving and the way everything went. It was just less violent and more PG-13. I feel like this still could have been like a USA or I don't know. The only thing is they showed boob. And I know, I mean, I don't think USA did, unless maybe at night it did. I'm trying to think of when I used to watch the horror movies. I feel like it was all censored, but maybe I'm wrong. Either way, loved it. Everything kind of fit together. We killed Slain at the end, so Richard Mull is gone. Connor lives, but maybe he dips for a while because he's taken off. And now it's Duncan and Tessa. I don't know where the adventure is going to go, but we're in the woods and we're starting fresh next one. I'm jumping in to Barry season 4, which is starting in 5 minutes. You guys want to see more of what I do? Full unedited episodes, all the shows on the channel. In the description of every video is a link for Patreon. If you're seeing this on YouTube, we are probably several episodes ahead, maybe further. We're going to run with the show if the edits work out good. If not, we'll see how it does on Patreon. But either way, I really enjoyed what I saw. In the link is Patreon, Peaky Blinders, Doctor Who, Person of Interest, Legend of Korra, Death Note, hundreds of other shows and movies. Check the link. If not, comments down below, like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.